Hi there, and welcome to this video. I'm Rick Vanover from Veeam. One of the most popular ways to recover is a virtual machine recovery. There are so many different ways to recover: instant recovery, file level recovery, virtual disk recovery, recover to the cloud, so many different ways. But one of the more popular ways that people do for different types of problems is the entire virtual machine recovery. So what I'm gonna do in this video is walk you through that, starting with a real problem, and we're gonna get a system back up and running really quick and easy. Let's jump into the lab and take a look. So what I'm looking at here is a system, 06. It's got a problem. So let's say, for example, my users let me know there's something wrong with it. Let's take a look at the console. Oh, that's no good. Let's reboot it. That's always the first way to fix something, right? But no, we still have a problem here. Now with Veeam, it's easier to just restore sometimes than it is to try to fix some of these problems. So from the restore menu, we can go ahead and launch the VMware recovery options, and this applies for Hyper-V as well. But I'm gonna go ahead and do an entire virtual machine recovery. So the entire virtual machine recovery is really a good way to preserve things like its placement in the organization from the virtual infrastructure perspective and more, or I could put it somewhere else, but it's right here in the middle, entire VM recovery. So let's go ahead and find that system 06 and do a recovery. So I can browse the infrastructure or I can browse the backups. Here's a little trick. If you click on that last restore point, click, click, sort, sort, you'll find the most recent restore point, which usually is where you want to go. Now I have one less than a day ago. There's 06. Let's go ahead and restore that system. So when we click next, I have a screen of very important options. I could restore to the original location. I have something suspicious with this virtual machine. The operating system isn't working, but the infrastructure is okay, so I'm gonna go back. But if I had a problem with the site or the storage or the network or the hosts, I might wanna go to a different location. And then also, if I had a data quality situation, I could use the staged restore capability. Staged restore will prepare the data on the image being recovered so that you're not going to be uncompliant for something like GDPR. And then also in the bottom, there's the option to do a quick rollback, which is basically doing changed block tracking in reverse. There's a lot of ways that you can do these recoveries. That one's really helpful, quick rollback, as long as you know that the infrastructure is okay. But we're just gonna do the restore to the original location. Now, I don't really know why that operating system stopped working on that. So I'm gonna go ahead and do what I call secure restore. I'm gonna do a malware scan on this system as I recover. I think that's really an important option. It is optional, but it's a really powerful way that you can have an additional level of confidence that what you recover is ready to go. And there's handling at the bottom that if something is found, do I restore it but not connect it to the network or just stop? So let's go ahead and launch this recovery. This is the entire VM recovery, and it's going to fix that system here. So one of the things it's also going to do, it's going to tell me that, hey, that virtual machine is still there and powered on. It'll be powered off, and it's going to alert me to that, which will at least let me know that the infrastructure will be changed in that regard, and I have the option to power this system on during the recovery. The secure restore, that's a really important option. I've selected that, so let's get into it. Now, the secure restore does add a few moments to the recovery, but I think in some situations where a cyber threat is maybe part of the what happened type of question, it's definitely worth the time. And as you go through a recovery, you'll see that it'll perform a scan, and then you can see right here that no threats were detected on the C drive, the bigger volume, and basically the rest of the drive will be recovered. Now, I will say I did speed this video up through the magic of television, but I think just those few minutes for that scan was actually worth it in some scenarios, especially because I don't know what happened. So the whole disk of the whole virtual machine has been recovered, and then the very last option is to prepare the virtual disks and move all of that data back. Now, I love watching the progress of these things. This is also logged with Veeam One, another part of the Veeam data platform. I'll be able to log into the restore operator activity report and see that this report, this recovery has happened. And then if I go back into the virtual infrastructure, I log back in, Windows is back up. So just like that, we can do entire virtual machine recoveries with these. Do you want to see different types of recoveries? Let us know. We are looking at the comments of these videos. We can do additional demos of specific things that you want to see. Happy to do that. And if you want to do these types of recoveries, you got to have Veeam. So go over to veeam.com and you can download the community edition. That capability that I just demoed is available in the free community edition, as well as a fully functioning trial. So either way, see us over at veeam.com and let us know if there's any more types of demos that you want to see.